Characterization. Why is it important for the modeling of photovoltaic materials and devices? Welcome to the characterization part of this course, where in the coming week and a half we will answer this question, discussing the characterization of PV materials and devices and their importance in the context of PV modeling. For the purpose of this course, we will use the term characterization to indicate a set of processes and measurements used to determine the properties of PV materials and devices. These characteristics are fundamental inputs for all types of simulations. For this reason, they must be carefully and precisely worked out to avoid wrong simulation results. Several characterization methods are usually employed in the field of photovoltaics. In general, they can be grouped in five categories: optical characterization, electrical characterization, analysis and morphology, structure and composition, and the determination of the device performance. Each of these five aspects is essential for the success of simulations and must be carried out before the proper modeling activity can start. Optical characterization includes techniques that determine the optical properties of materials. These can be used as inputs for optical simulations. The optical properties are mainly the refractive index and absorption coefficient of such materials. Moreover, these measurements can be used to obtain additional information on materials and films. Examples are the density of defects, the thickness, and the roughness of thin layers, such as the ones commonly present in solar cells. Several methods are used in the photovoltaic sector to characterize the optical properties of materials. In this course, we will focus on spectrophotometry, which allows the measurement of wavelength-dependent reflectance and transmittance of layers and devices. We will then discuss ellipsometry, one of the main techniques to determine the refractive index and absorption coefficient of materials. Both spectrophotometry and ellipsometry can be also used to obtain the thickness and the roughness of thin layers. Finally, we will talk about spectroscopy, in particular photothermal deflection spectroscopy, known as PDS, and the Fourier transform photocurrent spectroscopy, or FTPS. These two methods are particularly useful for the analysis of defects and sub-band gap absorption in layers and solar cells. Electrical characterization is used to determine the electronic behavior of materials, which are then used as input for electrical simulations. The most important properties that can be analyzed are the lifetime of charge carriers, the conductivity of materials and layers, and the concentration of doping. Among the various available methods, we will discuss measurements of carrier lifetime using the quasi-steady-state photoconductance method, abbreviated to QSSPC, and the photoluminescence, or PL. For the conductivity characterization, we will focus on dark conductivity measurements, which can also give information on the doping concentration by calculating the activation energy of a doped material. The characterization of the morphology of layers and solar cells is carried out to obtain information on the geometry of a photovoltaic device. These are useful to correctly build up models in both optical and electrical simulations. The most important parameters are the thickness and the surface roughness of layers and solar cells. As already mentioned, spectrophotometry and ellipsometry can be used to determine these two aspects. Other methods include different types of microscopy, like atomic force, scanning electron, and the tunneling electron microscopy. The characterization of structure and composition gives information on a material at the atomistic level. In particular, the crystal structure and the chemical composition of materials can be determined. This information can be useful for some types of simulations, like ab initio modeling based on the density functional theory. In addition, the knowledge of a material crystal structure and the chemical composition is important for the modeling of some optical and electrical properties, for example, in the case of ellipsometry measurements. To determine the crystal structure of layers, methods like X-ray diffraction and the Raman spectroscopy are commonly used. For the chemical composition, we will focus on the secondary ion mass spectroscopy and the Auger electron spectroscopy. Finally, we will talk about the characterization of PV devices. These measurements determine the external performance of a device. This is useful to evaluate the quality of simulations in the process known as calibration of modeling platform. The performance is determined as function of the electrical potential in so-called current density voltage measurements and as a function of spectrum in quantum efficiency measurements. JV measurements can be conducted in the dark and under illumination to understand a solar cell electronic behavior. Regarding the quantum efficiency, it is important to measure the EQE, the external quantum efficiency, but also to calculate the IQE, or internal quantum efficiency, to better understand the optical and electrical behavior of a PV device. Before we begin with the discussion of different measurements, it is important to talk about the importance of a correct characterization. The correct characterization of a PV material and the devices is fundamental to obtain accurate results with simulations. The optical, electrical, morphological, structural, and compositional properties are all crucial inputs of optoelectrical simulations. Also, the measured performance of devices is important for the calibration of simulations. Modeling can give incorrect results if the wrong input properties are used or if the device performance is incorrectly measured. For these reasons, material properties and the device performance need to be determined in the best and widest possible way, commonly as function of four parameters: electrical potential, temperature, intensity of light, and spectral distribution. Only if all these four aspects are taken into consideration, the results of modeling can be trusted. With this message, we conclude this introduction to the characterization of PV materials and devices. In coming videos, we will talk about the various measurements and their relevance to the modeling of PV devices.